Now, my brothers and sisters, I'm going to write something on the board now. What am I writing? Now, the devil will want me to stop right there. Because then you say, I got him now. I'm going to put something there. Praise the Lord. My brothers and sisters, 2025 plus or minus means something to every believer in the Word of God. It means something to even the historian who knows history, or the scientist who knows science, or the economist who knows economy, or the collapsologist who knows about the collapse of society. Everyone who are experts in every field of knowledge, if you listen to the reality, they will tell us that there's something significant about what is happening. 2025, what's the next two words? Plus or minus. Inspiration says that the thinking men will recognize, that the wise men, they will recognize we're on the verge of a great and stupendous crisis. Worldwide, global in scope. Before the first coming of Christ, there was a time of trouble. Before the second coming of Christ, there's a time of trouble. Did the wise men know about a coming time of trouble before the first coming of Christ? Yes or no? Yes. And when they spoke of what they knew, it troubled everybody when the wise men began to tell them about everything collapsing. They were troubled, but not only the world. Guess who else was troubled? Seventh-day Adventists. When you start talking about 2025 plus or minus, you know what happens to the majority of Seventh-day Adventists when they hear that word? They begin to tremble and are troubled, just like at the first coming of Christ. When we could have known had we studied the prophecies. Sometimes you say something like this, and you know when somebody comes up, they say, well, old minister, you can't say 2025 plus or minus. That's not so. I can't believe that's 2025, because how could I ever get ready if it's 2025? That's not a way to make a decision. Well, I don't think that this could be in the world, because if it's in the world, that would mean I only have a few years left, so that can't be. That's not evidence. That's not history. That's not science. That's not Bible. That's foolishness. My brothers and sisters, if Jesus died on the cross in 31 AD, about 4,000 years of human history had gone off the scene. About how much time would be left? About 2,000. You add 2,000 to 31 AD, you're going to get what? Talk to me, somebody. 2031, but because we don't know the exact time that sin started, guess what it tells us? 2031, guess what? Plus or minus. Not definite time, but the generation. That's what the wise men said. Same years. We cannot say day and hour, but we can know that there is a limit. So where does 2025 come in? You see, 6,000 years takes us to when Jesus comes back the second time, but as Seventh-day Adventists, we don't have until 6,000 years. A little bit before 2031 plus or minus, a little bit before the 6,000, something's going to pass on this earth. What is that? It's going to pass. Talk to somebody. Sunday law crisis, 2025 plus or minus. But I don't actually believe me, not because I say so, but because facts say so. God is telling us that we're to look at the weight of evidence and then make our decision. What do you say? I want to show you by the grace of God that the weight of evidence says, I promise you, listen to me very carefully. It will be a divine miracle. A what? It will be a divine miracle for us to make it to 2025 without a crisis. Now, if I make a statement like that, we should be able to go back to history, science, to economy, to all of the fields of knowledge, to go back, most importantly, to the Bible and verify that all of these things are what has been said. Do we need to do this? Yes or no? Do you want to do this with me? Because my brothers and sisters, I want to tell us what we're studying is making the exodus and the Adventist home. If ever there was a time to make an exit out of the Babylonian worldly system, it is now onto God's plan, so that by God's grace, we can be in position to finish the work. It's now, brothers and sisters. Now is it high time to awake out of sleep. Why? For now is our salvation nearer than what? My brothers and sisters, what I want us to see is that God is trying to show us something about an exodus that must be made. Listen, do you know that we will never become the friend of God unless we make the exodus? Do you want to make this exodus with me, yes or no? Do you believe that the time has come, yes or no? 2025, bless the money, that's it! I promise you. You want a little more? I mean, you better put on your seatbelts now. If you get nothing else tonight, get this. The greatest thing we can do right now is become the friend of God.